amazing.
There are 1.1 million workers in the hotel and restaurant industry in the Philippines alone, 9.5 million in Europe, and 212 million in the United States. Vast investments have been made in construction of local assets in the country. Pacor Entertainment City, Boracay Equestrian Club, Misibis Bay, Balyaroca Resorts, and the Balasin Island Club in Quezon. And a noteworthy surge in foreign hotel ventures, Marriott Group of Hotels, Raffles and Fairmont Hotel, Holiday Inn, Ritz-Carlton, Movenpick Hotels, Discovery Premier, and recently, Marco Polo. This then positions hospitality as the world's fastest growing industry and an impending and stable means of moving up and forward both for the Philippines and the Filipinos. This sets the gauge of a feasible, impressive economic growth. The Asian School of Hospitality Arts, the only hotel school in the country, is tailored to fit the demands of the hospitality industry. It is strongly founded by its competent core courses, Bachelor of Science in Hotel and Restaurant Management, Bachelor of Science in Tourism, and Bachelor of Science in Entrepreneurship, and made stronger by its intricate and specific career-driven programs, professional cooking with certificate in hotel and restaurant operations, barista with certificate in hotel and restaurant operations, certificate in professional cooking series, diploma in hospitality management, management in accounting, and soon, specialized butler service. Implementing a uniquely Filipino hospitality culture and teaching paradigm is ASHA's Lifeblood, a faculty roster comprised of seasoned hoteliers and veterans who have had years of industry experience both here and abroad. ASHA prides itself with its Earn and Learn program, which holds a strong affinity between education and employment, making it possible to extend both quality education and a stable source of living across more than 7,100 islands. Wisely situated in various locations in the country, ASHA simulates and imparts actual training in hotel grounds, further empowering the institution or its notable partners, TESDA, Commission on Higher Education, Tagaytay Highlands, Manila Ocean Park, Waterfront Manila Pavilion Hotel, Hotel H2O and Manila Oceanarium, The Island Cove Hotel and Leisure Park, Cravings, C2 Classic Cuisine, Seven Suites Hotel Observatory, The Orange Place Hotel, and the Center for Culinary Arts Manila. Over the years, ASHA has witnessed dreams being brought to life. Corinne Pastor and Joshua Delio are cooks at Ritz-Carlton, Florida, USA. John Jester Cruz, food and beverage staff at Royal Caribbean Cruise Liner. Jay-Z Mendonez, bartender in Singapore. Jeff Patriarca, baker in Dubai. Over the years, ASHA has taken the Filipino dream to the world. The Asian School of Hospitality Arts, the home of the future global hospitality leaders.
Good evening, mga e-estudyante. Welcome to another episode of ASHA Eskwela, brought to you by ASHA Free Education Online. Ako nga pala si Dr. Angie Blanco, Dean ng ASHA, Asian School of Hospitality Arts, located in Camias, Quezon City and Antipolo City. At today, tayo ay matututo ng magkasama. Ang ating episode ngayon ay tungkol sa bartending. So meron tayong guest. He will speak about bartending, no, types of bar, and the organizational chart of the bar. Siya ay galing sa barko. So mamaya, tatanungin natin siya kung paano ba magbarko, di ba? So let's welcome Mr. Nelson Navarro.
Yes, good evening students, good evening ladies and gentlemen, good evening Dean Angie. Well, tonight, This will be our episode number 8. So we'll be discussing the bartending introduction. So this brought to you by our ASHA, Asian School of Hospitality Arts, E-Skwela. For this afternoon, we will give you the subject of bartending introduction. And our topic for this evening will be the bar. Ang pag-uusapan po natin for this afternoon is about bar. Okay? What will be our objective or yung tinatawag nating ILO or intended learning outcome? So, we will at the end of this episode, the participants or the students can explain the term bar. Okay? Number 2, know the bar different organizational chart. Number 3, identify the parts of the bar. Number 4, differentiate the types of the bar. And lastly, we have also a short cocktail demonstration. So we will discuss about some tools and equipment, glasses, and we will mix at least 3 famous international cocktails. So namely, screwdriver, margarita, and tequila sunrise. Okay, next. So I will give you a little bit introduction about this bartending course. Ano po ba itong ating bartender course? So right now, most of our students like HRM, BS HRM students, BS tourism graduates, or BS entrepreneur students, after graduating into school or after graduation, ang lahat sa atin ay gustong makapaghanap kaagad ng trabaho. So, which is ang iba, hindi naman pinapalad na makapag-start kaagad ng work. Although we have a certificate or degree in a BS HRM or BS Tourism, but I will advise also na kung saan ay pwede tayong mag-take ng other trainings or seminars. Like for example, we have these integrated courses na kung saan may mga integrated courses kasama rin housekeeping, food and service trainings, and bartending. But if you want a specific course, like for example, I will focus to this bartending course. If you really wanted to be a bar stop or real bartender, okay, you will take this course, particular yung course na bartending. So makakapagtrabaho ka sa mga hotels and restaurants, sa mga establishment ng like entertainment industry, like hotels, casino, like Okada or the Resorts World or even Solaire. You have a chance also to work sa mga international resorts guys sa Caribbean, sa Grenada Island or sa island wherein mga sikat gaya ng Greece or Dubai resorts. And mostly yung ating pinapangarap, okay? Yung makapagtrabaho sa isang cruise line. Okay, if you are working on hospitality, marami kasing position diyan na pwede nyong applyan. But I will give you the inspiration na makapagtrabaho sa cruise ship as a bar stop or ma-achieve natin position ng bartender. Because working in a cruise line, hindi naman napakadaling pasukin. Nandiyan yung napakaraming requirements na kakailanganin, trainings na dapat atinan, yung pagod at hirap natin na kukunin sa pag-a-apply. So lahat yan ay hindi naman madali. Pero because of our dreams, lahat naman ito ay magiging success. Kung tayo ay mangangarap at tutuparin ang ating pangarap na may buong katuparan at pananalig lamang na ito ay makamit. So working in a cruise line, okay, ay magkakaroon ka ng incentives na malaki, which is yung salary package. You will earn your basic salary, of course, you're gonna earn dollars. Additional tips, like for example, if you travel in Europe, you will be accept or receiving a tips of euro. If you're traveling around UK, of course, you're gonna receive extra tips, yung tinatawag natin pounds, plus yung tinatawag natin tips and gratuity at the end of the cruise, babayaran ka or yung mga nabenta mong drinks, nabenta mo ng bottle of wine, lahat yan ay may corresponding gratuity or certain amount, yung tinatawag na bonus. Okay? So, eventually, malaki talaga ang sweldo sa pagbabarko. In my experiences, working as a bartender on board, kahit hindi ako graduate ng HRM, ay nakapag-work ako sa cruise ship dahil na rin sa mga inatinang kong seminars. That will be advantage for you. But before we proceed to our trainings or to the ating lecture, let me introduce first myself. Okay, my name is Nelson Navarro, presently working cruise ship at Viking Ocean Cruise Line. I started my career working in a B-ship, Holland America Lines, and yung HURTIGRUTEN ship. They're the one number one leading ship when it comes to traveling the Antarctica. So they called expedition ships. So I am affiliated member of organization of a bartender named Philippine Bartenders League. I joined this group way back 1998. So I joined this group international PBL, the Philippine Bartenders League. They're the one handling the bartender to be a member. Then at the same time, they're giving privilege for trainings and competition. They handle competition. So pag member ka ng ganitong samahan, you will be entitled to compete a competition. So during my younger years as a bartender, I was awarded as the first Cali competition champion way back 1991. That was at Holiday Inn. So PBL is also affiliated member of the International Bartender Association. So pwede tayo makipag-compete internationally. Pwede natin sabihin tayo ay makipag-compete sa iba't ibang mga nationality around the world. Like for example, the European and American bartenders. We are affiliated member of this organization. So sa bartending introduction, ayun nga sabi ko kanina, if you work in a cruise line, maraming struggle din ang ating may experience dealing with other nationalities. Isa sa mga factors, minsan medyo ma-homesick tayo, normal lang yan. Pero sabi ko nga sa inyo, habang tumatagal, lahat naman ito ay ating napaglalabanan because of this good salary package. Okay, to start with our course, let's define first the meaning of the bar. So a bar is a place or area where drinks are mixed and served to customer and to fill server orders, a place for relaxation. It is also a control center in which record is kept of the stock on hand, the drinks poured and their sales value. The bartender provide almost any drinks or mixed drinks that guests may desire. Well, I will describe this definition of bar into four easy words to remember. Let's start with the mix and serve. So normally, bar is a place where the bartender can mix and serve the drinks. So dito natin makikita ang bartender nagmi-mix ng drinks. At the same time, dito rin kinukuha ng mga waiters ang mga drinks na order ng mga guests natin. So it is easily remembered, a bar is a place for a mix and serve. So number two, a place for relaxation. Like for example, if you have your birthday or a group gathering, you will go to the bar just to relax, to unwind. You just easily ordered a bottle of beer or either a bottle of wine, a glass of wine, for you to relax. So it's a place for relaxation. Number three, control area or a control center. So bar is a place for control center because dito sa bar, makikita natin ang different kinds of beers, liqueurs, lahat, makikita natin dyan. Either yung pinakamamahaling alak, gaya ng Louis XIII na nagkakahalaga ng $1,000. So imagine ang per shot ng Louis XIII sa Pilipinas is about 5,000 per shot. So imagine kung hindi natin ikukontrol ito, itinatawag natin inventory. So pwede itong i-consume ng mga bartender na nagne-neglect sa kanilang responsibilities. Pwede nating tikman ng isang drinks pero yung talaga i-consume natin sa one bottle is a no-no policy when it comes to bar operation. That's why we have this implementing a bar inventory. This will be either a basic daily inventory, a weekly inventory or a monthly basis inventory. Napakahalaga na mayroong isang control pagdating sa bar operation. And lastly, the bartender. So basically, bartender is a person who in charge for the operation of the bar. Siya yung tinatawag na master of personality pagdating sa bar. Siya yung nagtitimpla ng drinks, siya yung nag-serve ng drinks sa customer, at siya na yung tumatay yung little big boss pagdating sa operation ng bar. We will discuss more about this bartender position as we continue to our topic or to our more to our this topic for this afternoon. But before that, we will discuss first the organizational charts. So ano-ano ba yung mga position na bumubuo sa isang department dito sa bar department na ito? So this organizational chart, ang ating boss or ating manager is the one, is the OIC or yung tinatawag na big boss natin sa bar department. By the way, bar manager is also called as a beverage manager. Sa cruise ship, we called bar manager as a beverage manager. So siya yung pinaka-amo natin or pinaka-boss natin sa bar department. She or he is headed by assistant bar manager with a bar supervisor, normally two bar supervisor. One supervisor work in daily, sa pang-umaga, and other one is yung evening shift supervisor. This supervisor is the one in charge for the entire operation of the bar. Like for example, sa cruise ship, we have 8 to 10 outlets, including casino, sports bar, 3 restaurants. We have pool bars. So if you will assign to the pool bars, so mainit pero relax dahil nandyan, napakagandang ambience. You will see the view outside and the fresh air. So you will be acting as a bar supervisor na rin, yung mga bartender. Like in my experience, bartender is also called as a media supervisor because we're the one who giving the assignment of the bar waitress. Kami yung gumagawa ng station assignment nila. Like for example, sa isang lounge, it consists of 3 stations. So we're the one giving the station assignment for the bar waiter. We're also doing the schedule of the bar waitress and cocktail waitress. So under the bartender, under nyo yung mga bar waiter and cocktail waitress. This bar staff, they're the one who's serving the drinks. So it's sila yung mga bar staff na umiikot sa lounges or sa lounge or sa bar area, sila yung kumukuha ng drinks sa customer. After taking order to the guest or to the customer, they will give the order or send order to the bartender. So their main responsibilities is to take order and to serve drinks to our guests. So that will be the responsibilities of the bar waiter or the cocktail waitress. So dako naman tayo sa bar boy. Ang bar boy, yung tinatawag natin bar utility. These bar utilities are very, hindi madaling trabaho para sa akin. Although hindi ako nag-start ng position ng bar boy, pero masasabi kong nandito rin kasi yung buhay ng isang bar operation sa ating mga bar boy. They are the one who set up or helping the bartender or the bar waiter to set up the bar. At the same time, yung closing the bar. In charge of slicing, preparing our garnishes, preparing our ice, making sure that all our needed batters and stock needed before the operation, sila ang naghahanda niyan. Ang medyo mahirap nga dyan yung pag-uugas ng baso. Although we're using the glass machines. But because working in a cruise ship, there are about 2,000 to 3,000 guests on board. So imagine napakaraming highball glasses, cocktail glasses at pag-uugasan ng isang barboy. So of course, tulong-tulong din naman yan. Hindi naman lahat pinaubaya sa barboy. Pag sinapit natin yung barboy, hindi naman porky barboy sila, lahat naman ng trabaho ibibigay natin sa kanila. As a ideal bartender or ideal bar waitress, tulong-tulong tayo. Kasi kung ano naman yung magiging outcome ng successful ng ating outlet, magiging credit naman sa atin lahat yan. So matutuwa yung ating bar manager, of course. So ito rin sinasabi ko nyo, we're now going to this position bartender. Since I will encourage everybody na pag pumasok tayo sa bartending industry, we took a bartending training, we achieved to be a bartender someday. Although mag-start tayo sa bar waiter or a bar boy, bar waiter, bar boy, pero ito yung masabi kong relax na yung position mo, nandito ka na sa pagiging bartender. Tayo yung magtitimpla ng drinks, tayo yung pinupuntahan ng waiter. So like a chef, we're doing this cocktail, okay, cocktails. Instead of cooking the dishes, we're the one mixing the drinks. So imagine, napakaraming drinks, around 1,000 different cocktail drinks We have non-alcohol drinks also. We have specialty drinks, hot drinks. So minsan, we put a little bit showmanship or tinatawag nating flaring the bottles. Because I would say the bartender is also considered as an entertainer. Because ini-entertain natin yung guests na kung saan hindi lang tayo nagtitimpla ng drinks, we will entertain them aside from giving them a nice bar jokes, bar tricks. We will try to flare the bottles. Kunyari, kukuha tayo ng bottle of gin. So bago natin serve yung bote, we will do a little bit flaring to entertain our guests. Or before we pick up a piece of glass, we will throw it behind the back. So kakatch natin yung eyes. So imagine, you give entertainment to your guests. So after that entertainment, of course, ano pa yung expect natin? Magkaroon ng extra tips. Yung sinasabi ko, it depends on how you deliver your service to your guests. Pero naman yung service, minsan namumutawi na sa ating ano yan eh, sa atin. Hindi na natin siya ginigay ng effort. Kusa siya lumalabas. Kasi gusto natin yung ginagawa natin. Gusto natin yung trabaho natin. Which is talagang kitang-kita sa personality natin yung pagbibigay natin ng smile when we rendering our service to our guests. Because bartender, aside from having good talent and skills, you are a skilled tradesman. Ibig sabihin, alam mo rin yung mga produkto mo. Ibig sabihin, hindi ka na nagtitimpla, alam mo kung ano yung history ng drinks na ginawa mo, yung history ng isang bote o isang gin, alam mo yung history. Because some guests, sometimes upo yan sa bar, he will be order about cocktails. Like for example, the guest ordered to you, okay, bartender, give me a screwdriver. So sometimes, yung drinks na in-order sa screwdriver, minsan doon ka makakakuha ng point of view na kung saan i-open yung topic para mapag-usapan nyo ang isang bagay. Because so yung mga guests yan, uupo sa bar, minsan tahimik sila eh. If you will not start the conversation, minsan di sila magsasalita. Pero ang dapat yan, aside from giving a ready smile, you will open conversation. At the same time, you have an open ear or sympathetic ear na makikinig sa kanilang mga problema. But please avoid lang, no? Advice lang, please avoid delivering topics about politics or yung religion. So, ayan yung i-avoid natin. So, we can start the topic by serving, sir, you're ordering a screwdriver. A little bit history, sir. You know, but way back 1938, screwdriver is a drink composed of vodka and orange juice. But because they don't have a stirrer around to the area, this person working in the oil rig pick up the screwdriver to stir the drinks. So after that, the drink screwdriver is yun na nagsimula yung history na tinawag yung drink na screwdriver as a normal name, screwdriver. So we will tackle it later as we doing it in our demonstration later. We will discuss about the screwdriver. Malalaman natin yan later on sa ating cocktail demonstration. So next will be a bartender, no? working onboard the ship. Ito yung aking mga pictures. Recently pictures na may kita nyo. Ayan, I have a ready smile. Medyo pogi, pero syempre mas pogi pa rin kayo kaysa sa akin. So really masabi ko, no? Always ready, give you ready smile. Whatever day na pagpasok nyo, medyo may konting problema because you're working on board, always give your smile. Okay? Always give a big smile to your guests. Okay? Para magkaroon na rin ng attraction, good vibes. Now, we will proceed to our parts of the bar. There are three parts of the bar. We will start to the front bar. So, what is front bar? Front bar, it is the counter area of the bar where customers order their drinks. So, eto na, no? Yung naka-highlight na color yellow, that will be the front bar na kung saan may kita natin a bar counter. So, dyan sineserve ng bartender ang kanyang drinks to the customer. Consists of different or how many bar stools or bar chairs. So, that's the perfect example of the front of the bar. So, that's the number one parts of the bar. Next, number two, we have the back bar. So, ano naman itong back bar? Back bar is an area where bottles of liqueurs and rows of sparkling glassware are displayed. As you can see to our image, okay, back bar is a consist of different kinds of liqueurs. Nandiyan yung mga mamahalin to our premium, to standard cocktails. At the same time, yung display ng mga elegant glasswares. At the same time, may kita rin natin sa back bar yung tinatawag natin mga signages o yung mga marketing promo. Like for example, beer, like for Budweiser or signages na tinatawag na cocktails. So, part siya ng kanilang marketing strategy. May kita natin yan sa back bar. So, number three yung ating tinatawag na underbar. So, eto na yon. Ano ba tong underbar? So, underbar is the heart of the entire bar operation and deserves the most careful attention. So, this time, may kita natin sa image, no? Eto talaga yung setup ng bar. Okay, focus tayo sa underbar. This the picture was taken on board sa aking paboritong lounge sa Viking Ocean Cruise Line. Ito yung tinatawag na veranda. It's an open deck na i-slide yung door, no? Ikita natin yung ambience sa labas at yung swimming pool. But let's focus to this parts of the bar, the underbar. Nandito yung tinatawag nating mga under the chiller, yung beer chiller, yung glass chiller. This is the working place, working stations ng bartender. Dito siya nagka-cut ng garnishes. Dito naka-prepare yung mga, may kita natin sa picture, yung mga ice, yung mga juices. Then yung naka-highlight na color yellow na circle, that space is called speed rack. Okay? Take note, speed rack or speed rare. So nandito yung mga standard ingredients ng gagamitan ng isang bartender sa pagkitimpla. Nandyan yung pouring brand niya. Let's say, we call it pouring brand. Like for example, sa pag-mix natin ng cocktail drinks, hindi mo tayo pwede gumamit ng mga mamahalin. We call it pouring brand. Like for the basic gin, we use Gilby's. For the basic brandy, we use Mondador. For the basic rum, we use Standway rum. Sa Pilipinas, Standway rum. But because on board, sometimes we use Bacardi rum. So itong naka-circle na yellow na to, we call it speed rack. So dito naka-place yung mga standard bottles na gagamitin ng bartender pagka nagkaroon na ng normal operation, kailangan ito ay laging ready. From liqueurs down to liqueurs, like yung mga grenadine syrup, yung mga juices, sour mix, orange juice, pineapple juice, so on and so forth. Like for example, bitters and other kinds. So may kita rin natin dyan yung tinatawag na microsystem. Ayun yung ordering system na kung saan dyan makikita yung mga orders ng mga waiters. So dyan mag-a-appear yung orders ng mga bar servers. So yan tinatawag na micros machine. So that will be our underbar. So now we will proceed to our next types of the bar. So there are three types of bar also. Dapat din natin malaman kung anong kahalagahan na malaman natin ang types of the bar. So ano-ano nga ba ito? Okay, first, we will start defining the permanent bar or the stand-up bar. What is a permanent bar? Permanent bar is a bar that forms an integral part of the interior design and decoration of the outlet. So basically, when we constructed a bar and restaurant, so kasama na siya sa integral part, kasama na siya sa interior design ng isang establishment. Like for example, there are some areas called as dining area, reception area, kitchen area, housekeeping area. Ito rin yung kasama na yung tinatawag natin bar area. So, constructed na siya at kasama na siya sa interior design ng isang outlet. So, as you can see to our image, eh, no? Stand-up bar or permanent bar. So next, yung ating tinatawag na service bar. So service bar, it refers to a bar that pours a drink to table service only. Okay? Table service only. Take note. Usually, in a conjunction of the outlet. So this time, service bar, ito yung place na kung saan part siya ng permanent bar. Normally, nasa corner siya. Okay? Tanging ang service bartender ay naka-assign sa service bar. Ang normally responsibilities nitong service bartender is to mix only the drinks, no? Ang imimix na lang drinks, ang gagawin niya mga drinks diyan ay yung lamang mga drinks na order ng mga waiter at waitresses galing doon sa ating dining area. So yung mga waitress o order sa bartender. So they're not going to the permanent bar, no? Kasi ang trabaho ng permanent bar bartender is to mix the drinks doon sa mga guests na nakaupo doon sa bar counter. This time, service bar, doon lang o-order ang mga waiters, ang mga servers, doon lamang o-order sa service bar. Kaya normally, naka-located siya sa corner. Okay? The only obligation of this service bar bartender is to mix only the drinks na order ng mga waiter na nasa guest sa floor. Okay? And lastly, the mobile bar or portable bar. So, this bar that is movable can be transferred from one place to another. So, as you can see to our illustration, to the image, there will be different kinds of mobile bar. No? First, yung tinatawag natin setup lang ng table. So, table siya, ordinary table, lalagyan lang natin ng skirting, table skirting, then pwede na natin ilagay yung ating mga needed bottles of liquors and spirits, beer. So, normally, setup po lang sa isang corner kung saan yung function na gaganapin yung isang activities. So, lalagyan mo lang siya ng little bit design ng skirting. Then, that's it. That will be make us a portable bar. Yung number two, yung type ng portable bar na merong four wheels. So, napakadali ring setup nito. So, all you have to do is to set up your your portable bar with complete set of your bar stock. Then, ipupush mo lang siya. Itulak mo lang siya dun sa proper station na kung saan na ilulocate yung beverage disposing area nyo. So, it also composed of ice, garnish, kompleto na siya. Plus, number three, yung ating picture number three. So, may kita nyo, that's the typical example of the mobile bar. So, ako yan, no? I was invited to cater this occasion last February, itong year na to. So, 100 packs siya. So, parang reception. I bring the mobile of the bar setup to the reception area. So, ayan yung mga sikat na nakita natin ngayon, mga mobile bar. They will cater these drinks instead of catering you the food. This time, yung mga drinks naman ang dadalhin natin dun sa area. So, that's the perfect example of the mobile bar. Okay? I hope everything give you a little bit introduction to the bartending. So, after this, we will proceed to our cocktail demonstration. We are going to show you the most three famous cocktail drinks we have mixed for today. Yeah.
Up with my girl last night, so I went to the club.
So I went to the club.
Put on a fresh white suit and a mini coupe, sitting on dubs.
Sitting on dubs.
I'm just looking for somebody to talk to and show me some love.
Show me some love.
If you know what I mean. Everybody jacking me as soon as I stepped in the spot.
I stepped in the spot.
200 and I'm building, ain't none of them hot.
Ain't none of them hot.
Except for this pretty young thing that was working all the way at the top.
All the way at the top.
Shouted, what is her name?
Ooh, she made us drinks to drink. We drunk and we
got drunk.
And man, I think she thinks I'm cool. She gave me a wink, I winked back. And man, I think that we hit it off something proper.
Good afternoon once again, and we are now proceed to our cocktail demonstration. For this afternoon, we're gonna make at least three famous international cocktail drinks, namely margarita, tequila sunrise, and the screwdriver. But before I proceed to the cocktail demonstration, I'm gonna show you first what will be our tools or equipment that we're gonna use for our cocktails. First, we start with our jigger. This jigger measurement that we're gonna use for our cocktails, meaning one jigger is equivalent to 31.75 ml. So this equipment is called jigger. Then we have the shaker. We have the three-way shaker. So it consists of three parts. Then we have another shaker, which is the Boston shaker. So this is the tin part and the glass part. We have a bar spoon for our drinks that we need to stir. We're gonna use the pour spout or pourer. We're gonna put it on the bottle to control the flow of liquid or the alcohol that we're gonna use later on. Okay, to start with, we have also discussed about the glass we're gonna use. We have the margarita glass or the champagne saucer, and we have the tumbler or the highball glass. Okay, I'm gonna first show you how to make the margarita. So margarita is composed of tequila, triple sec, and sour mix, lemon sour mix. First, we're gonna put in our shaker. So tequila, we're gonna use tequila. Tequila is originated in Mexico, made in agave. So we're gonna take the jigger. So one shot of tequila. Then we have the triple sec, 3/4 jigger of triple sec. And we have the sour mix, 1 jigger of sour mix. First, we have the procedure to coat it, the rim of the glass. So we have to use the slice of lemon. So we're gonna do like this. Then grab the iodized salt. So we can create the rim, salted rim. Now we have to shake our cocktail, or do like this. Okay. Then slice off lemon or lime. So this will be our margarita, our first cocktail drinks. Now we're gonna proceed to the second cocktail, which is the screwdriver. Screwdriver, this time we're gonna use highball glass, put with ice. So one jigger, one shot of vodka. Then fill it up with orange juice. Then garnish with a slice of orange. So for this procedure, we use the method of stir. By the way, this method for the margarita, we use the method of shaking. We use the shaker. Again, for the screwdriver, we use the method of stir. Now we're going to the third and last cocktails, which is the tequila sunrise. So we get another highball glass, fill it up with ice. So we have one shot again of tequila. and orange juice. Fill it up with orange juice. This time we're gonna put the grenadine syrup. Put it on the center. This will be create the sunrise effect. So don't stir. So babayalan natin na magkaroon siya ng effect na parang nagkaroon tayo ng sunrise. So that will be a combination of orange and the grenadine syrup. Then after that, of course, put a straw. This time we use the method of build. So no stir, just leave it like that. So once again, to before I end up the demonstration, I'm gonna make a quick recap. So margarita, we use a method of shaking using our shaker. For the tequila sunrise, we use the method of stir. And for the screwdriver, we use the method of stir. And for the tequila sunrise, we use the method of build. So once again, thank you very much. I hope you enjoy our cocktail demonstration for this afternoon. And have a nice day and see you once again.
Yun.
Wow, so ang dami nating natutunan ngayong gabi ah. Napakinggan niyo ba lahat 'yon, ha? Nag-take down ba kayo ng notes? So review lang natin, no? Bar, the place where you mix drinks. Ang tao doon yung bartender, siya yung nagmi-mix ng drinks. Saka mga cocktail, saka mga wine. Then you have parts of the bar. Front bar, back bar, at underbar.
Yeah.
And then underbar. You have types of bar, permanent bar, service bar, at mobile, portable bar. And then nag-demo si sir, no? You had the margarita, tequila sunrise, and screwdriver. Wow, congratulations. Dami niyong natutunan. So, paano ka ba nag-umpisa mag-bartender, Nelson?
Yes, ma'am. Good evening
ano
again,
students. Ano mo naisipan na gusto mo mag-bartender?
Well, actually, ma'am, as I mentioned nga kanina sa introduction ko, actually, ma'am, hindi naman po talaga ako graduate ng any hospitality courses or HRM or tourism. Actually, I'm engineering graduate. But yung travel ko, ma'am, kasi gusto ko talaga makapag-travel around the world. So sabi ko, ano, may napakadaling pamamaraan para makapag-travel. Kasi hilig ako magbiyahe, ma'am, eh. So napasok ako dito sa isang agency na nag-cater ng mga bars, mga staff na nagdi-deploy sa mga hotels. So I attended some training and seminars so para matutunan ko yung pagtitimpla ng alak. So I concentrated the position para magkaroon ng position na bartender. I took this training bartending course. So na-assign po ako sa Shangri-La as a assistant bar waiter right away. So parang 2 to 3 days ako nag-bar boy, then after that they assigned me as a assistant bar waiter sa Shangri-La. Way back 1995 po yun, ma'am. So after that, naging confident po ako, nag-apply po ako after po that experience, nag-apply po ako sa iba't ibang hotels. Then nagtrabaho din po ako sa Super Ferry Inter-Island Vessel. So yung experience ko doon, yun na po yun, ma'am. Talagang sabi ko pwede na siguro akong pumalaot sa international shipping. So nag-apply po ako sa iba't ibang shipping company. Hindi rin po napakadali. Minsan sasabihin added additional experiences pa. Pero hindi naman po ako pinahinaan ng loob. Sabi ko nga, kung talagang dream nyo ang isang bagay, is talagang pag gusto mo ikapabong abutin ito, hindi ka kagad panghinaan ng loob. Madidinay ka sa first, twice, pangatlo, pero continue ka pa rin. So yun, ma'am, nakuha ko yung pag-work sa cruise ship. My first position was bartender right away, working in the B-ship company. Way back 1999 po yun, ma'am. Yan. Then after that, nasundan na po, nakapagtrabaho na ako sa Holland America Line, sa recently po currently sa Viking Ocean Cruise Line.
So ano yung qualifications? Dapat ba graduate ka? yun nga, ma'am. Dapat training ka ng bartender.
Yun, yun.
At mas add experience.
Po, yun, no po. Mas maganda talaga, ma'am, graduate ka ng hospitality courses like BHRM, BSHRM, tourism, or either entrepreneurship. Mas maganda, meron ka mga trainings na naatinan. Gaya ng TESDA, training for bartending course, for barista course. Pero sabi ko
okay,
nga
yung
po.
Yung NC2 na bar, oh, no?
Yan, yan. Yes, ma'am. Kasi gaya nga po sa akin, di naman po ako talaga graduate ng mga hospitality.
Saka F&B service.
Yan po, yan. Makakatulong po sa atin yan. Magiging advantage po natin yan sa ibang aplikante na meron po tayong added trainings. Yan. So meron po tinatawag na integrated training seminar. Meron po talaga yung focus lang sa bartending course. Talagang doon ka lang talaga nakafocus doon sa bartending course.
Oh, aking bagay, may training ka sa bartending, sa F&B service, no?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
tapos
ma'am.
Tapos, ilang years experience ang kailangan mo? Para kami
well, actually, matanggap. Ma'am, some companies, ma'am, they accept at least a 1 year experience.
Kung meron ka 1 year sa 5-star hotel. Ayan,
yes, ma'am. Yeah, 3-star, yeah, 3-star or 5%. Pero kung meron ka naman po experience sa mga restaurants, yung mga fine dining restaurants gaya ng TJ Fridays, at least mga 2 years, ma'am, masasabi na natin medyo ano ka na diyan. Medyo may laban ka na sa mga shipping company pwede ka nang apply. 2 years sa restaurant.
So, mga 2 years hotel, no? Or sa high-class na bar. Okay
yan,
ka na.
Year,
okay na, okay
yeah,
ka na sa cruise line.
Opo, 1 year sa
at
hotel.
At saka syempre, yung mga training natin sa TESDA.
Yan, ma'am.
At saka
yan,
sa
ma'am. Opo. Yung training natin sa TESDA. Yan. National certificate.
So, ang advice mo sa ating mga estudyante na susumikap na magkaroon ng trabaho at saka maka-abroad? Magtrabaho sa cruise ship, anong advice mo sa kanila?
Yun po, ma'am, no. Ang advice ko lang sa kanila is try and try lang, no. Pag-apply lang tayo with our experiences, with our trainings, yung ating mga credentials. Pag in-apply natin yan, ilalagay sa resumes natin, mababasa ng mga employer. Minsan madi-deny tayo. Hindi naman masama yung madi-deny tayo ng unang apply, pangalawang apply. Try lang tayo, pasa natin sa mga different companies through email. So send natin siya sa iba't ibang company. Then after yung continue learning, no, attend some seminars. May mga pagkakataon, attend lang tayo ng mga seminars. Like for example, yung ino-offer ng TESDA, attend lang tayo na yan. May mga libreng mga trainings yung ibang LGU. So grab lang natin yan. Continue learning. At darating yung araw na talagang makakamit natin yung makapagtrabaho sa ating pinapangarap na cruise ship. Yan.
Wow, ang dami nating natutunan ngayon at saka advice pa direct from Mr. Nelson Navarro. Talagang galing siya, nag-umpisa talaga siya sa baba hanggang nakamit niya yung kanyang bartending job at naka-around the world na siya.
Yes.
Idol, ha? Idol ka pala.
Yes, ma'am. Mali, pag bartending, mamasaya ka yan eh. Parang nag-entertain ka ng mga guests mo. Misa, nagtuturo ka ng bottle.
So, importante, di ba? Masaya ka sa ginagawa
masaya,
mo.
Masaya, yan. Totoo
at
yan,
saka,
ma'am.
Saka love mo yung yan. Job mo.
Yan, totoo yan, ma'am.
Pababayaan.
Yeah, kasi pag talaga mahal mo yung trabaho mo, misa, kusa na lang lumalabas yung ano eh, quality service mo sa guests eh. Hindi mo siya talaga kukusa. Talagang dumarating na nai-enjoy mo yung trabaho mo, yung guest na binibigay na service mo sa guests, parang ano lang, normal lang siya. Walang halong pagbabalat kayo kung tawagin.
Mamaya.
Talaga yung service na binibigay mo sa guest is talaga nagagaling sa puso mo. Yun nga, pag nagustuhan ka ng guest, minsan they will give you appreciation, i-recommend ka sa manager mo, sabihin na, oy, you have a nice bar staff, your bartend is very accommodating. So bibigyan ka agad ng magandang appraisal. So mababasa ng manager mo yan, well, a chance for you to, of course, yung ma-build up yung personality mo. At yun yung sasabi ko kanina, yung effort na makatanggap ka ng extra tips. Yan, kasama na yan syempre.
At sa bartending, sa cruise ship, I'm sure malaki sweldo, no?
Yes,
marami
ma'am,
ka nang naipon, ha? Para sa pamilya.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so salamat, Mr. Nelson Navarro. Marami kaming natutunan sa bartending at sa pagtatrabaho sa cruise line. Itong mga estudyante natin, talagang dream nila na maka-abroad eh, lalo na dyan sa cruise line.
Yes.
So, salamat. And guys, I hope marami kayong natutunan today. And kung may questions kayo, sulat nyo lang dito sa chat box. Remember, mag-attendance din kayo ngayon, no? Para dun sa ating attendance. And next week, mas madami pa tayong kaalaman na lessons para sa inyo. More on bartending from Mr. Nelson Navarro next week, Friday din, no? So again, ako si Dean Angie ng ASHA Eskwela. Tulong-tulong tayo para mapalawak ang ating kaalaman. Tandaan, sa ASHA, may pag-ASHA. Bye! See you next week!